Today's class of banana disease will start at 10:30 a.m. A very good morning to all of you. Today we are discussing the most important lecture in plant diseases, that is banana disease or banana diseases. So as per now, today we are discussing seven different type of diseases of banana, under which we are studying about the plant quarantine disease. Quarantine disease is nothing but the viral disease of banana and fungal diseases as well as bacterial diseases. So to start with today's lecture on banana disease, the first disease we are going to learn about yellow stigmatoca leaf spot, Mycosporella muscicola, caused by Cercospora musii or black leaf spot, Mycosporella fidensis, or sometimes based on this pathogen causal organism, yellow stigmatoca might be called as pseudo Cercospora musii. This was commonly asking question in last previous JRF or SRF questions. So yellow stigmatoca leaf spot was caused by Cercospora musii or Mycosporella muscicola. After that, black stigmatoca was caused by Mycosporella fidensis or Paracercospora fidensis, sexual set, Paracercospora fidensis. So now for as concern, black stigmatoca is not prevalent in India. As per now, black stigmatoca is not prevalent, but yellow stigmatoca leaf spot was commonly seen in banana cultivated areas. So first disease was observed in Java, 1902. So as per epidemic causes in 1913 in Stigmatoca Valley in Fiji. So nowadays we all know South India is made for banana cultivation, and mostly areas we will see banana eating people also. Every day at least we will eat one banana normally, commonly. Apart from other food, so many try to purchase only banana. Some philosophers will say daily eating two bananas keep healthy, no need of breakfast also. Instead of breakfast we can eat banana, two bananas. Significant losses are caused by in banana due to foliage and reduction of functional leaf surface of the plant. So this is the brief introduction about banana. Now we will see the symptoms. These symptoms, earlier symptoms for any disease, earlier symptoms causes in lower leaf. Earlier symptoms of lower leaf. Initially, small reddish brown speckles or small reddish brown symptoms were seen near the tip of margin. Specks may also produce near the midrib even sometimes. These specks, how it looks like, clearly it was shown here. Spindle shaped spots were seen with reddish brown margin, and a yellow halo will be there. So for symptoms, first symptom, lower lip was seen. Next symptom, reddish brown specks was seen. Third symptom, this specks was spindle shaped spot surrounded by yellow halo. Then after soon, this midrib enlarges from the spot and towards the margin of lamellae. Total leaf will turn with this symptom. So after that, spot collapses and entire spot area appear dried. Here you can see picture, the dried area you are seeing here. So for this is gradually from lower leaf it starts. After that, upper leaf also it will carry out. This is all about clear symptoms. And fruit, if we see fruit, whenever the disease of stigmatoca was there, the fruits were not developed prematurely, but underdeveloped premature fruits we were seeing. After that, this is all about the symptoms we were discussed. Actually, it was causes on young leaf, followed by it will reddish speck was seen. Soon after midrib, enlarges into the total leaf.
Sir, voice break hai bahut sir.
Enlarges into the leaf. Then after, spindle-shaped spots on foliage with gray center we were seen. So this is all about the symptoms. Now coming to survival and spread. Survival and spread. We all know Mycosporella muscicola, ascospore, sexual state, ascospore or sexual spores will be the major cause. Through ascospore, primary infection will be there. Secondary spread through wind-borne conidia and ascospore. Sometimes infection takes place through stomata on the lower surface of young leaf. If there will be presence of surface moisture, suppose for mostly fungal pathogens, moisture is requisite to initiate the disease. Surface moisture is necessary for release of both conidia and ascospore. Please remember, survival and spread is important through ascospore. Mycosporella fusicora will cause primary infection. Through wind-borne conidia, it causes secondary infection. Now coming to favorable conditions. High humidity, heavy dew, and rainy weather with temperature above 21 degrees centigrade. Soils with poor drainage and lower fertility soils favor the disease incidence. Presence of weeds and increase in number of suckers in a mat promote disease development. This is about favorable conditions. Now coming to management. Nowadays, management, biological management is enlarging and growing the things. So for Sigatoka disease control, Vodex mixture 1% plus linseed oil 2%. Spraying Vodex mixture 1% plus linseed oil 2% spraying will reduce the losses caused by Sigatoka, and spray Jinab 0.25% is also effective, as well as copper oxychloride also effective. Now coming to spraying schedule, chlorothalonil 0.2%, carbendazim or thiophenate methyl 0.1%, mancozeb 0.2%, along with wetting agents like tea pool, sandalwood, added to that will increase the efficiency of this spray. So management as per concern, Vodex mixture plus linseed oil is effective, or Jinab copper oxychloride suspend mineral oil also effective. Now coming to Panama beet. So far as concern, Fusarium oxysporum cubens, we have one interesting thing over here, Fusarium musae in banana after post harvest causes enormous amount of damage to the fruits of banana. Fusarium musae, post harvest disease. This is emerging disease in India for GRF, ARS, SRF. They might ask you the questions, emerging diseases. Fusarium musae is emerging disease in banana. So for first reported in Australia 1876, Panama wilt. We all know wilt caused by Fusarium. Fusarium is a soil-borne plant pathogen. As per Fusarium concerns, primary spread is actually through chlamydospores in infected suckers, followed by secondary infection is through macro and micro conidia. We all know that soil-borne plant pathogen, Fusarium oxysporum primary spread is through chlamydospore, secondary spread is through micro or macro conidia. This is very important bit. The popular variety Gros Michel, mostly grown for export quality fruits, because of susceptibility to Panama wilt, Cavendish bananas was adopted or replaced by Gros Michel. So, Amrutpani, Karpuravalli, Gros Michel, these three became highly susceptible to Panama wilt. So, very important bit is Panama disease tropical ray spore is considered one of the most destructive disease of Panama plant worldwide. There are four races. As per concern in Fusarium species, tropical race 4 is considered as most destructive race in India and also worldwide. Now, if we are seeing these symptoms clearly showing that Panama wilt fungus actually attacks the root first. From the root, pseudostem, it will enter into the plant And they might seem that actually Panama wilt, one thing is there, it was occurring mostly in old plants comparing to new plants. Although 2-3 months old plants are favorable, but 5 to 6 months or 5 months old plants is mostly susceptible to Panama wilt. Remember this point. Next, symptoms initially seen in older plants. In Panama wilt, symptoms initially seen in older plants. If we take in Sigatoka, it was initially seen in upper leaf. Now, in Panama wilt, it was seen in older plants. So, the earliest symptom will be faint yellowish streak-like thing. Faint yellowish streak-like thing. Clearly seen here, faint yellowing, yellow streaks were seen, oldest and lowest most leaves. Then, longitudinal splitting. Longitudinal splitting will be there. Or discoloration of vascular strands in pseudostem. Discoloration of vascular strands in pseudostem is commonly seen. So these older leaf sheets are extended to inner leaf sheets. First, normally older leaf sheet will get this disease. Soon after, this fusarium enters into the newer leaf sheet. So for symptoms as concerned, fungus first attacks root. As soon as 3 to 5 month old plants are most favorable, seen in older plants, yellow streaks will be seen. Longitudinal splitting of pseudostem is most common. Discoloration of vascular bundles will be seen. So next thing is, in symptoms, rhizome of affected plant. Rhizome of affected plant will be given bad odor. Bad odor only seen in Panama wilt of banana. This is very important question. Odor of rotten fish will be there. Odor of rotten fish will be there. Younger sucker also developed symptoms, but it was very rarely. This was seen by you clearly. Here actually what happens, as soon as the fusarium occupies, longitudinal splitting will be there. There the burrowing nematode, Rhodopholis similis pre-deposits. Okay, these are the common symptoms. Longitudinal splitting, discoloration, total yellowing streaking will be there. These are the most common symptoms. And after this attack, fruits are malformed. Actually, fruits are malformed, ripen maturely or irregularly. Already I told you survival and spread, chlamydospore, microconidia and macroconidia. Not only that, actually saturated, poorly drained heavy soil was the main cause of favorable condition. So then also insect injury and wounds was caused by nematode Rhodophilus similis, I already told you. Generally greater in acidic or light textured soil. So here we are seeing in favorable condition, light textured soils favorable the diseases. So alkaline soils or clay or using lime content or high calcium content is one of the reasons to take up the management practices. Normal management practices are disease-free suckers we have to use, avoid ill-drained soils, following of crop rotation with good-yield soil, application of lime 1 or 2 kg per pit by taking the plant, dipping of suckers in carbon dioxide 0.1%, neem cake plus trichoderma viridae. Remember, biocontrol agent, neem cake plus trichoderma viridae should be applied in planting pits. So soil trench with 0.2% carbon dioxide is most effective. So resistant varieties are some are there. Cavendish, it is this all are Basrai, Vamankeli or Dwarf Cavendish, we will say for this. Vamankeli or Dwarf Cavendish, we will say Huang, Karpura Chakkar Keli. Dwarf varieties are growing mostly seen. So for next disease, one fungal wilt we have seen. Now we are seeing bacterial wilt. Bacterial wilt caused by Rhalostonia solanaceae. This one is, please remember, race 2. Rhalostonia solanaceae were caused by race 2 pathogen. Fusarium were caused by race 4 pathogen. Most important thing. So, Buckleradia is also a sexual space of bacteria. Pseudomonas, we can say, Rhalastonia solanacea are commonly causes. First reported in Guyana in 1840 in Moco plantation. In India, West Bengal in 1968. So far, the symptoms was concerned. This is a common story. Actually, one farmer will ask, my leaves are turning yellowing and they're becoming brown. What should I do? Or the fruits ripen too early and the flower wilt. What should I do? Or he will ask, fresh fruit turn black. What should I do? So these are the common things will get by the farmer. So for this, what the thing we have to do? After cutting down the disinfected parts, we have to bund it. Cut down all the plant parts at ground level when it was infected with banana, wilt caused by bacteria, Rhalastonia solanaceae, and dig a hole in the middle of them and make it. Then after, preventing bacterial wilt is most common thing. The whole dead plant, we have to kill it and bund it. This is the common thing. So for common inspections, we will see this kind of wilt symptoms. Rhalastonia solanaceae 1 to 4 flagella might be present. This was seen like this. So now coming to common symptoms. Symptoms start on young plants, mostly. Moco disease or bacterial wilt. Symptoms start on young plants. Then as we were concerned, Panama wilt was caused in older plants. Now Moco disease or bacterial wilt was caused in young plants. This is the main major differences. The youngest 3 to 4 leaves. The youngest 3 to 4 leaves will get attacked mostly. The youngest 3 to 4 leaves will get attacked mostly. At the junction of lamella and petiole, we will see clear ooch-like discoloration. Soon after, vascular strands will discolor and blackening of suckers we will see. Blackening of suckers we will see soon after. So, bacterial ooch was seen in pseudostem. Here also we will see some kind of bacterial ooch clearly from the affected areas. From brown dry rot, dry rot within fruits, we can see through this bacterial wilt. These are the most common symptoms. Actually, first common symptom, youngest plants started symptoms. Next, lamella and petiole foliage junction, they will be there. Then, discoloration of vascular bundles will be seen. Then after that, brown bacterial ooch was seen commonly in the infected areas. Death of whole plants also occur. So for bacterial survival and spread, we all know bacterial cells in infected plants causes primary infection. Secondary infection is through irrigation water of bacterial cells. Now for management, growing resistant variety is mainly thing. Growing resistant variety. Soon after that, strict quarantine or phytosanitary measures we will take up. Or expose the soil to dry, hot weather is most important thing. After that, disinfection tools with formaldehyde 1:3 ratio along with water. Crop rotation with sugarcane or rice should be followed. Fumigation with methyl bromide or chloroprixin. Very important thing is fumigation with methyl bromide or chloroprixin. Fumigation with methyl bromide or chloroprixin is most important. Then after biocontrol agents like Pseudomonas fluorescens, Trichoderma viridae is most commonly used for bacterial wilt. So, Moco disease is caused by race 2 Rhalastonia solanaceae and it infect another weeds or host like Helicolina species. It is having 1 to 4 flagella rod-shaped bacterium. They are gram negative. Okay. Bacterial cells in disease infected suckers will cause primary infection. Through irrigation water implements and wind causes secondary infection. A brief view on Moco disease is caused by Rhalastonia solanaceae race first reported in Guyana in 1840, not reported yet from in India. Please remember, this is a common point. Bacterial wilt of MoCo disease was not reported in India up to now. Then after symptoms was seen in younger plants, followed by coalesce near the junction, blackening of succus will be there, brown bacterial ooze will come out. Under severe infection, the whole plant will die. This is a common thing. So after that, Irvinia rhizome rot. This is also a bacterial disease. Irvinia rhizome rot or Irvinia crotovara or Irvinia chrysanthemi. Irvinia crotovara, Irvinia chrysanthemi is the common species of Irvinia rhizome rot. Actually, the symptoms of this disease, this is also seen in young plants. Please remember, now as per we studied two bacterial disease, that one is first bacterial wilt, followed by we are studying rhizome rot of Irvinia. These two are attacked in younger stage only, as per Fusarium wilt was attacked in older plants. Please remember, initial stages. Soon after that, young sprouting suckers will be there. Young sprouting suckers in rhizome will be there, newly infection. Pseudostem. Pseudostem, actually what it might happen, soft rottening of pseudostem we will see. Soft rottening of pseudostem we will see. It will actually first turn brown, then soon after will become necrotic. The plants will get easily, when we pick up, the pseudostem will become very loosened. So, breaking caused by rotting at the ground level commonly seen. Actually, these sprouting suckers will have more water-soaked lesion like spots will be there. If we go to that plant and we will see water dropped or soaked symptoms we will see. And soon after, rotting will be there, easily picked up. This survival, again bacteria. I already told you, bacterial disease primary spread is through bacterial cells in soil or plant suckers. Secondary infection is through irrigation water. What is the favorable condition? So we are thinking Irvinia, we all know it is having total flagella throughout the body. So what are the things, favorable conditions for this bacteria? Actually, bacteria mostly grown on 37 degrees centigrade. Water logging condition should be there. Juvenile stage, actually younger plants were more infected, we are seeing. Juvenile stage of crop is highly susceptible. Then after, growing susceptible cultivars like Cavendish, Stella Chakrakeli, and some other varieties mostly favors the disease. Cavendish or Stella Chakrakeli mostly favor the disease. Favorable conditions is juvenile stage are highly susceptible, first point. Second point is higher temperature, 37 degrees in earlier stages of the crop. Third point is water logger conditions favors the Irvinia chrysanthemi. Fourth point is growing susceptible conditions are cultivars like Cavendish, Stella Chakrakeli. Now, if we take management, avoid susceptible cultivars, as I told you, Stella Chakrakeli, Cavendish, Bassarai, Vamankeli. These are most, avoid those waterlogged conditions. We should be come up to control these diseases. After that, crop rotation with rice or sugarcane for 2 to 3 years. Crop rotation is most effective way to manage the Irvinia diseases. So only healthy suckers are planted. These suckers dip in copper oxychloride 5 g/L. Please remember, copper oxychloride 5 g/L plus monocrotophos 2.5 ml/L is mostly useful. Maintain proper soil, aeration also helps. Then after, grow cowpea in interspaces to reduce soil moisture. Then after common management practices what's in. So, as per concern, Irvinia chrysanthemi or Irvinia rhizome rot is caused by Irvinia crotovara, usually seen in younger plants. Sprouting or soft rottening will be there. Scanty roots will be there. Pocket of dark water soaked symptoms will be there. So, to come up these, avoid planting susceptible varieties. Dip the suckers in copper oxychloride plus monocrotophos. Benzedine infected suckers with bleaching powder is most common. Now we are moving to next most important disease of banana diseases. This is bunchy top, curly top, cabbage top, Strangel's disease. There are four names for this disease: bunchy top, curly top, cabbage top, Strangel's disease. So this will be also called as banana bunchy top virus. Banana bunchy top virus, BBTV. In short form, so many will say BBTV. First reported from Fiji in 1889 in Cavendish variety. Please remember, first reporting are important for all competitive exams. In dwarf Cavendish varieties, it was seen mostly. After that, actually in 1914, it was introduced in India from Sri Lanka through cyclone. So cyclones are becoming a major threat from one country to another country to bring the diseases or to bring the spores of any common diseases. So for the virus is a domestic quarantine pest in India. So actually this all the viruses of banana, what we are studying, like banana bunchy top, banana mosaic, banana bract mosaic, these three are under quarantine, domestic quarantine pests in India, most commonly asked questions for all competitive exams. Hence, movement of planting sucker from Northeast, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka and Kerala to other parts of country is banned because in this area the disease is more. So for the genetic material, banana BBTV as a single standard DNA. The next disease we will study, it contains single standard RNA, that is banana mosaic or cucumber mosaic virus. Please remember this point. It is very important for any competitive exam. Banana bunchy top, curly top, cabbage top, Strangel disease, nucleic acid is single standard DNA with isometric particle. So as for the symptoms were concerned, these symptoms are very important. At any stage, the disease can occur. First point. Next, the lamella will become pale in color. First, intervenal necrosis, we will say. Intervenal necrosis was most common. Next point is Morse code. Morse code will be there. What is Morse code? Prominent dark green streaks on petioles. Prominent dark green streaks on petioles along midrib and leaf veins will be there. That one we will see. Dark green dots are continuous dark green lines will be there, means we will say that it has Morse code. So infected plants show marked stunting also. Sometimes leaves are reduced in size and narrow lamella or shortened petiole will be there. Shortened internodal length will be there because of this common disease. Tip of inflorescence bracts of infected plants remain green. Please remember, tip of infected bracts of infected plants remain green and do not turn into any other color. This is common symptoms. Actually, bunchy top appearance will be there. Bunchy top appearance will be there in banana or curly top, we will say, cabbage top, we will say. These all are commonly seen symptoms in this. So, survival. Virus particles through diseased suckers is the primary spread. Most important, 100% upcoming questions in any objective is virus particle transmitted by banana black aphid. That is, banana bunchy top virus was transmitted by banana black aphid. What we will tell that as Pentalonia nigro nervosa. Please remember, very important bit. Pentalonia nigro nervosa, virus particle transmitted by banana black aphid. Apart from this, Colocasia isculenta serves as latent reservoir host. These two are most important. Other species are there like Cucumis sativa, Cucumis mellow, Keratomus rosees. These all are common. Mostly two are important. Pentalonia nigro nervosa, Colocasia isculenta. So as per disease cycle is this, favorable conditions. Increasing temperature from February onwards, we will see. This is the main cause for virus spread and symptom expression. As like we are looking now, corona also from March, it was spreading more. As like that, if we compare banana bunchy top also from February onwards, the disease will become more and more. Infected reservoir host like Colocasia esculenta also favors the diseases. Prevalence of vector also may be the most common. Next, strict quarantine measures we should adopt to avoid from South India, mostly commonly to the North India. Again, 2,4-D or injecting herbicides we use to kill all the infected plants are alternative hosts by monitoring all the plants. So vector control is by phosphomidine at the rate 1 ml per liter or methyl dimethoate. Or methyl dimethone or dimethoate 2 ml per liter is most commonly used in vector control. Raising barrier crops like sun hemp in 3 to 4 rows on the field boundaries to check aphid vector. Most common thing for banana bunchy top virus is raising crops like sun hemp is mostly useful. Please remember. So after that, Colocasia plants will be avoided. Next disease we are moving on, that is banana mosaic. These were the BBTV, banana bunchy top virus. These are the banana black aphid like Pentelonia nigronerosa, I told you. These were the isometric single stranded DNA particle you are seeing here. Then after, we are coming to banana mosaic. This will be also called as infectious chlorosis or heart rot. So banana bunchy top, different names is curly top, cabbage top, Sprengel's disease, first reported in Fiji in 1889. But this virus is also a domestic quarantine pest from Gujarat and Maharashtra to other parts of the country is banned. Cucumber mosaic virus is under a group of Cucumovirus, spherical particle. Please remember, most important point. Banana mosaic is spherical particle, cucumovirus group having single stranded RNA. These are the most common thing. This virus having domestic quarantine from Gujarat and Maharashtra. From Gujarat and Maharashtra, the banana crop are not transported to other parts of the country. So these are some common symptoms of single stranded RNA virus and the pig. Actually, what happens in the symptom? Mosaic-like or discontinuous linear streaking will be there. We will call as midrib running parallel to the veins. There will be a typical mosaic like or discontinuous linear streaking will be there. Leaf size will be reduced. Next point, infectious chlorosis will be there. Means chlorosis of new emerged leaf. The emerged leaf will become totally yellow in color. Next, heart rot. We are saying that banana mosaic or infectious chlorosis or heart rot. We are calling it as three names. It means three symptoms it has to signify. Heart rot is nothing but central engaged leaf and leaf sheath. Central engaged leaf and leaf sheath will become rotting. That's why it is called as heart rot. Then after, diseased plants do not reach maturity and fail to produce any bunch of bananas. The primary spread is virus particle through infected suckers which were affected by virus. Secondary spread, this also very important for any competitive exam, for any examination purpose. Virus particle transmitted by banana black aphid again, but this is not Pentelonia nigronerosa. This is Aphis gossypi, Aphis maiadis, Cucumis sativa, serves as a latent reservoir host. In that, Pentelonia nigronerosa and Colocasia esculenta act as a latent reservoir host. In this, Cucumis sativa serves as a latent reservoir host. Aphis gossypi, Aphis maiadis, aphid, these two are most common diseases. So for favorable conditions, latent and post-monsoon period mostly favors the virus. prevalence of infected reservoir host, prevalence of vector. There will be more vector means the disease will be more. Now coming to management. Strict quarantine methods should be adopted. Use of disease-free suckers for planting. Dry heat treatment of sucker at 40 degrees centigrade for one day. Dry heat treatment of sucker at 40 degrees centigrade for one day is most effective. Avoid growing cucurbit. Avoid growing cucurbit as intercrop. Please remember, raising barrier crops, again like sun hemp, is also most effective to control the black aphid. Raising sun hemp as barrier crop. Again, vector control with methyl dimethone or dimethoate or dimethoate 2 ml per liter at 3 to 4 week intervals we have to spray. Now coming to, this is a heart rot. We are seeing, I told you, actually, occasionally a central engaged leaf and leaf sheath became rotten. It will be looks like this symptom. So after that, this is the last disease, banana bract mosaic or banana bract mosaic virus. This virus disease was first reported in Kerala. Please remember, this virus disease was first reported in Kerala as Kokan disease. If anyone will ask you, Kokan disease means banana bract mosaic virus. It was reported first in Kerala as Kokan disease. So it was very rapidly spreading in banana growing state in absence of any regulation or movement of sucker. So this comes under a family of Poteovirus. Please kindly remember, banana mosaic virus is under Cucumovirus. Banana bract mosaic is under Poteovirus. So banana mosaic is spherical particle. Banana bract mosaic is long flexuous rod particle. These two are very important. Banana bract mosaic is long flexuous rod particle under group of Poteovirus. Banana mosaic is Cucumovirus caused by cucumber mosaic virus. This is spherical particle. Both are having same nucleic acid, that is single stranded RNA. Now coming to symptoms. Clearly seen in cooking banana also and Karpura Chakra Keli cultivars. We are using bananas for cooking also, and some Chakra Keli like bananas. Chakra Keli is mostly famous for more high sweetening. Everyone will like to eat Chakra Keli even. In cooking bananas, water soaked lesions will be there. If we see means water soaked lesions will be there. Then after followed by like Chakra Keli and other common cultivars like Cavendish, there will be a continuous or discontinuous pinkish streaks will be there. Please remember, kindly remember. Next after that, pinkish or purplish streaks will be there in the backs of inflorescence. Common thing, pinkish or purplish streaks will be there in backs of inflorescence. In severe cases, pink streaks from lower surface to the midrib, it can spread and the crown will become flattened. So like the flattened arrangement we will call as traveler's palm. This is the most common symptom in banana bract mosaic. Traveler's palm is most common symptom in cooking banana cultivars, we will see. Next, leaf sheath will become unclasped. It won't attach with another. Next point is pseudostem of infected plants bow or curve. Stem also with curve, and infected plants like fluorescence will become curve and prone to many wind speeds. So infected plant will become produce a small bunchy and brittle peduncle. So for symptoms, again I am telling, it was seen most commonly in cooking bananas. Continuous and discontinuous pinkish streaking will be there, soon after followed by pinkish to purplish streaks will affect the inflorescence even. It is very prone to front to wing, traveler palm like symptoms in the crown region will be there, small bunch of banana will be there. Now coming to survival. Actually, virus will spread vertically and disease will occur for this. Secondly, horizontally transmitted banana black aphid like Aphis coccytei, Aphis medis, as we studied earlier also, Rhacolocycium medis. These three are most commonly secondary diseases. After that, favorable conditions are disease spread and symptom expression in winter months most commonly. Winter months, prevalence of vector is also most common. Now coming to management, use of disease free sucker followed by dry heat again for 40 degrees centigrade for 1 day. Raising barrier crops like sun hemp is most common thing. Vector control methyl dimethone or methoate is most common thing. This was the class for today, and I am sharing you some important questions which was previously asked in all competitive exams last 10 years. I prepared in view of all competitive exams. These are the most common questions which were asked based on banana diseases. Panama wilt of banana is caused by, we studied just now only, Fusarium oxysporum. Which race 4, please remember. Panama wilt of banana is which type of disease? Simple interest disease, kindly remember. It won't spread much, but slowly it will occupy all the areas. Banana, bunchy top of banana was introduced in India from Sri Lanka through cyclone, we discussed. Most of the banana diseases are disseminated in primary infection is through suckers only. Sigatoka disease of banana is caused by Cercospora mucin or Pseudocercospora, we discussed mucin, or Paracercospora fecensis, Mycosporella fecensis, Mycosporella mucicola, anything they will ask. Next thing, banana mosaic is primarily transmitted through sucker. Moco disease of banana is caused by Rhalestonia solanaceae. Please remember that one is race 1. Banana bunchy top of banana was spread through Pentelonia nigronerosa. After that, Sigatoka disease of banana is effectively managed by, already I told you, Godex mixture plus linseed oil. These were most common use. They will ask you in many examinations. Bunchy top of banana is spread by Pentelonia nigronerosa and other colocasia like PC. This was banana black aphid. The restricted movement of banana planting material from Gujarat and Maharashtra, today also I told you, that one is banana mosaic disease. Flooding fallowing is effective management practices in Panama wilt. We discussed even before. Fusarium wilt causing pathogen survives in soil as Fusarium whenever will be there. This was primary infection due to Chlamydospore. Secondary infection is due to macro and micro conidia. Please remember. Domestic quarantine has imported against banana bunchy top diseases. This was the most important thing. Again, Fusarium diseases, asexual fruiting body produces by Sporodochia and fruiting body. Primary infection of Sigatoka leaf part of banana takes place through Ascospores. We discussed today also Sigatoka. Ascospores may cause primary infection. Acquisition of banana bunchy top virus takes place through NIM. Please remember. Banana bunchy top virus acquisition was take place through means. Bioagents, I told you today also, Panama wilt, Pseudomonas fluorescens plus Trichoderma viridae. Banana bunchy top virus contains the nucleus single stranded DNA. Other banana mosaic, banana bract mosaic is mainly due to single stranded RNA. Rhalestonia solanaceae race 2. And please kindly remember, nowadays very important question is, post-harvest banana diseases that was caused by Fusarium mucin, it is emerging disease. They will ask for you any competitive examination, like scientist post also, it was caused due to race 1. These are some common questions where we are getting nowadays. Apart from this, we will come up with other classes also, with other diseases.